Hello again, everybody, and welcome back to Marvel Mania. Today we'll be talking about a very interesting character, quite possibly the most powerful Marvel character in the entire Marvel Universe. His name is the One Above All, and he literally is the One Above All. He is the supreme ruler of the multiverse. Basically, he is deemed responsible for all of the existence of life throughout the multiverse. He is also the ultimate source of all love and good. Now, for any of you people who know any of these types of cosmic entities that live within the Marvel Universe, you would know that the Living Tribunal is one of the most powerful entities in the multiverse. But even he isn't on the same level or the same playing field as the One Above All. The Living Tribunal has even stated this himself, claiming that there's only one above the Living Tribunal. And another great explanation of the One Above All's true power was from when Thor compared himself and Odin to various other gods within the multiverse. He compared himself and Odin's powers to the likes of the Living Tribunal, explaining how it would be impossible for him to ever conceive power of that magnitude. So to have Thor, the god of thunder and son of Odin, be displayed as not even a fraction of the Living Tribunal's power, and then to think that the Living Tribunal isn't even at the top of the food chain, just kind of shows you how much power the One Above All really has. In this instance, Thor also stated that it humbled him to think about how much more powerful the creator of all universes has to be than all of his creations combined. So now, when you take into account all of the different things that you have in the entire Marvel multiverse, kind of goes to show how powerful the One Above All really is. There's not even much point in going over his powers or abilities because they are all just infinitely powerful. Yet he does have one weakness. His weakness is multiversal imbalance. You see, the One Above All created an object called the Astral Regulator, which is more powerful than the Infinity Stones themselves. The purpose of this object was to keep different universes from inside of the multiverse from clashing into each other. It kept them separate. But there was a moment in which Thanos was actually able to obtain one of these Astral Regulators, and that caused such a huge imbalance in the multiverse, even the One Above All was not able to fix it. And with the power of this Astral Regulator, he was able to defeat all of the abstract entities, including the Living Tribunal and the One Above All. He defeated and then absorbed all their power, becoming the most powerful being in the multiverse. Now, this all happened in the comic Thanos Infinity Ending, and the way that it ended is a bit confusing because the way that Thanos was even able to get the Astral Regulator was because a future version of Thanos was able to make a younger version of himself get it. And once they succeeded in that, they both combined into one Thanos again. But what the comic kind of explains at the end is that the younger version of Thanos didn't have the same mindset as the older Thanos. Because the future Thanos decided to, once he had all this power, just wipe out all of reality itself. But then what happened is the younger Thanos then took control of all the power and reversed everything back to the way it was. And so even though this was a generalization and there's a lot more detail into the storyline than what I just said, that's basically like the bigger picture of what happened. But as you can see, because of this Astral Regulator, the multiversal imbalance that can be created with it is the only possible weakness that the One Above All has. But anyway, that kind of wraps it up for our video about the One Above All. Now, if you guys like these types of videos about abstract or cosmic entities within the Marvel Universe, or, you know, just super powerful characters in general, just make sure to comment it down below. And once again, like always, if you enjoyed this video, don't be shy to leave a like or subscribe. And see you all later in the next video.